If you're curious about Isaac Newton's early note-taking habits, you will discover that he kept them by way of a waste book. Its remnants have been archived by the University of Cambridge and are publicly available. What I find interesting is that he used nothing more fancy than scratch paper to invent calculus, or at least the workings of it. Newton's notes were quite homely. They were no fancier than pen on paper. He quite literally used a book called a waste book, which I find absolutely fascinating. So, let's explore. Newton's commonplace beginnings. Isaac Newton appeared happily oblivious to the fancy things that we of modern society go for. Outside of formal publication and despite the gravity of his work, he was quite content doing his thing with recycled old paper mostly. This being the father of modern science, an adept of the alchemic mysteries, gravity, the laws of motion, the reflecting telescope, calculus, optics. And yet, only the most basic reverence for paper had he. The University of Cambridge is keeper to quite a number of Newton's works, and it's quite impressive. Let's see Newton's waste book, IDMS Ad 4004. It's about 935 pages in length. Many pages are filled, but there are a lot of blank pages as well, which was a feature of books archived from this era. So what's the story behind this book? According to the University of Cambridge, Newton had inherited bound papers, forming part of a commonplace book, which his stepfather had used for theological content. As you will see later, and as I quote, this consisted of hundreds of folios bound in pasteboard. Now, Newton was a man of absolute faith, but he had no regard for those. He just wanted its paper. I invite you to appraise all the faded prior text. One might see Newton's choice to scribble over theology as sacrilegious, yet Newton did have a more valuable purpose for what he considered to be waste. He took to remark on geometry, mathematics, and other important things. So I argue that even had there been sin in his scribbling on theological notes, one might find virtue in his acts still. Newton wrote in a rather free-form manner, content-wise, but he had a very structured way of formatting his notes. He left-aligned notes against a single vertical margin, a grid-like thing. That left side he kept mostly sparse, but for content headers and small diagrams, as you will see. This style might have either been his own, or that which he inherited from other contemporary commonplace traditions. The left-hand border reminds me of Cornell's note-taking style. He drew charts and diagrams. He aligned content in invisible tables, especially where they involved numbers. Newton had rather fine, small handwriting. I do not think he wrote that way for the cost of paper, which was available to the common man at the time and not inordinately expensive. There's a very good article at the Folger Shakespeare Library on this, which states that from the 1570s to the 1640s, the price of paper was 4 pence a quire, or roughly a penny for 6 sheets. Shakespeare lived from 1564, Newton was born in 1643. The price of paper could not have changed much from Shakespeare's time to Newton's, and Newton's own scholarly habits and need for paper would mean that he could have afforded paper. So I think it fair to assume that his handwriting in his waste book was more a stylistic or practical choice rather than a frugal one. Was Newton a careful scribbler? It doesn't seem so. He wrote quite as he pleased, meaning all over the place. There was rhyme and rhythm, but no perfection in his waste book. He did not bother to maintain it. And you can really see. Have a look. Blots, blots, jottings, smears, page rips, stains. Well, to be fair, we don't know if these were properties of the book itself when Newton had them, or whether that state of the book came about after centuries of disuse. And look at his redactions. There are X's all over his papers. And now the empty pages. The waste book contains quite a number of blank pages. These either had no chance to be used or were intentionally skipped for reasons unknown to me. I have to mention though, look at the way Newton wrote numbers. The serifs. When he wanted to write well, his handwriting was classically beautiful and quite intelligible. His writings have been transcribed cleanly. The link is in the description. There's one quote I love that's been dedicated to Newton. Nature and nature's laws lay hid at night. God said, "Let Newton be," and all was light. Alexander Pope. Newton's content management. Look at all these preserved redactions. Maths is all about rigorous proof, fundamental axioms, and observable workings. If one were to practice true science, then failed paths are just as valuable, if not more so, than successful experiments. You will know what doesn't work and can eliminate those paths from future workings. Newton seemed to rarely remove working content. I therefore have a key burning question in mind. How did he search for relevant notes amongst the many he took? The man was a prolific note-taker, to say the least. We know that in his other works he had handwritten indexes, content lists, and sorted topics. But search? And in the 1600s, in an age before search engines, it's a wonder how Newton would even know where a particular thought or note was first developed or would be located. I do like, however, that Google Scholar starts with a quote oft attributed to Newton, standing on the shoulder of giants. I personally use SQLite and RipRap for searching through and managing my notes. And I can't imagine living a scholarly life these days dependent entirely on paper for my learning and knowledge. I hope to look more into this aspect of Isaac Newton's workflow, and if you know anything more about it, please do share. I think the modern problem is that many of us take notes for note-taking's own sake rather than reflection's sake. I don't mean to knock off modern journals, bullet journals, and so on, but I find them artsy, too crafty. And I find that exhausting compared to Newton's note-taking style, which has none of that perfection of appearance. I keep extensive notes in my personal and professional life. My labor leads me to believe that notes need not look perfect, they just have to be accessible. This being an example from my own personal codex. Is there anything more exhausting than trying to look perfect all the time? I've always been one not to mind scratches or dents in my devices or anything I find precious like on my guitars. Imperfections add character and personality. When compiled for later use, yes, the notes can be touched up. Your notes to yourself are like letters of your heart. They should reflect the truth of your state of mind and knowledge at the time you made or recorded them. To me, that indicates a historical record, so why change history? Why would you want to change a set of notes that allow you to travel back into the past? Newton was quite clear of the nature of his temporary notes. They were for waste, a stepping stone to develop ideas upon. There was no need for beauty in a thinking pad. Which is why I must ask, what is a waste book? A waste book appears to have been treated like a scratchbook. It can be a temporary ledger or a place of thoughts before items are transcribed into a more permanent medium. There was Professor George Christoph Lichtenberg, a well-known and respected professor of experimental physics. He gave a description and comparison to merchants who had waste books. He explained how advantageous they could be to the ways of scholars. And so he said, the merchants have their waste book. This deserves to be imitated by scholars. First, a book in which I write everything as I see it or as my thoughts give it to me. This can be carried back into another one where the materials are more separated and ordered. I think this description is quite apt. It's like a brain cache, for which writing is thinking. I write to find out what I think, said Stephen King. Your pen of choice can be anything, be it quill or keyboard. What matters more is that you pen down your thoughts to help you think better. And how did Newton write to think? I love that he used his waste book to think and test the limits of his knowledge. And so it was that Newton gradually mastered all that he wanted to master, thanks to the early beginnings afforded by his waste book. Reading Newton's waste book really makes me think, do I need fancy, expensive, luxury notebooks? Sir Isaac Newton had no need for those. I'm no sir, and I'm the farthest reaches away from Isaac Newton. I probably don't need those. Thanks for dropping by. I appreciate your time and attention. If you enjoyed this video, do click like and please consider subscribing.